Hi, welcome to Coffee Break with Researchers. Today I'm having a very special coffee break with the winner of our PhD contest, David Ayrapetyan. He's a PhD candidate at the Leibniz Institute of Agricultural Development.
Coffee Break with Researchers presents you with cutting-edge insights on regional development and innovation. We ask researchers directly and in a personal manner about their work. We make scientific knowledge accessible to all.
David, it's a pleasure to have you here in Vienna. Welcome, how are you doing?
Thank you very much, I'm happy to be here.
And which coffee are you having?
I'm having a cappuccino made from Colombian coffee.
You like it?
I like it, thank you.
I'm very happy to hear that. I'm having, as usual, my Colombian black coffee. David, let's talk about your paper, The Role of Sustainability in the Emergence and Evolution of Bioeconomy Clusters. Could you please tell me what the paper is about?
Well, the paper is about how we can make the environment more sustainable by applying the concepts of bioeconomy and bioclusters. So the idea was that if we learn more about how bioclusters work, we can try to make them more sustainable.
And since this is the key concept of your paper, could you please define what bioclusters are?
Yes, so generally we don't find a bioeconomy firm in the middle of nowhere. These firms gather together in one locality and they cluster, so to say, themselves. And we use the term biocluster to mean that they cluster in one place.
Thank you for that. And could you tell us the main findings of your paper?
The main finding was that the actors in the biocluster, they don't actually work on making it more sustainable. We can say that they act just the way they do, and if and how this way of acting leads to sustainability is a different question. And in line with the definition of the bioeconomy, of course, this cluster was using renewable natural resources. And if you use them correctly, that's when the sustainability will come up. And another finding of the paper is then how this biocluster used them correctly in that case.
And tell us, please, what was the main motivation behind your paper? Why did you choose this PhD topic?
I was previously involved with the field of socio-ecological systems, and in this field you can understand how sustainability comes up by breaking down the system of human-nature interactions into its constituent parts, and then you see how these parts interact with each other over time, and through this interaction mechanism you can then see the mechanism of sustainability, how it comes up. And regarding the relevance, I mean, bioeconomy strategies are pursued by many countries nowadays to address the issues of environmental sustainability and climate change. And many policies do this through bioclusters because bioclusters offer the possibility to work both on technological development in the bioeconomy and also on environmental development.
Well, let's talk a bit about that now, about the policy implications of your paper. If you had a policymaker in front of you, what would you say?
I would say that if you want to make bioeconomy and specifically bioclusters more sustainable, you shouldn't really try to force sustainability directly. Instead, it's better to shape the conditions for sustainability to happen. Like in the case of our biocluster, the actors there, they didn't work on sustainability. They worked on new ways to valorize natural resources. They worked on improving trust among each other. They worked on creating new businesses. They worked also on new ways of sharing the available resources among each other in the most efficient way. And all these conditions together brought to a place where sustainability came in and of itself. And in this regard, I think I like to make this comparison that it's a more general principle in life, that if you want something new and valuable to happen in your life, you don't often force it directly. You instead create the conditions for it to happen, and then it can happen by itself. So it was interesting to observe a somewhat similar pattern in this case as well.
How nice reflection. Thank you for sharing that. And we have to let it flow, so maybe it comes naturally. David, it was a pleasure. Thank you so much also for this amazing Armenian candies, which I really enjoyed, chocolates with nuts. And it was really nice to read your paper. All the best for your defense of your PhD, and hope to see you next time as a doctor at our coffee break.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for watching. If you're interested in more details about this academic publication, you can find here the link below. Find us on Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube, or listen to our podcast on Spotify. See you next time. Bye-bye.